Barry, they'll kill her.
You're my best friend, and I'm worried that you're not right in the head.
The ransom is a manuscript I supposedly wrote that's coming true before my eyes.
It happened just the way it was on that page. So dark.
I have found only a few scattered pages.
I want the entire manuscript.
The deadline is in 2 days.
I found Mr. Wake's pages.
Good girl.
How the hell did she get her hands on the manuscript anyway?
I don't know. She's resourceful. I told you were too hard on her.
Listen, I found out all sorts of interesting stuff while I was digging around.
Yeah.
Mr. Wake, it's Sheriff Breaker. We have an FBI agent here, Agent Nightingale.
FBI?
He's anxious to see you. You'd better come to the station.
Okay, I'll be right over, Sheriff. Let's make this quick, huh?
Help you folks? Name's Randolph. I'm the manager.
We're looking for Rose. Works as a waitress down at the diner.
Rose, sure. Nice girl. Who wants to know?
I'm Alan Wake.
The writer, huh? I heard on the radio you were visiting. Well, I'll show you her trailer. That Rose, she's a nice girl. Always pays her rent on time.
As I was saying, Al, I found all sorts of weird stuff from the local newspaper's archives. This place is crazy! Disappearances, mysterious deaths, urban legends come true, and get this, most of this stuff takes place around Cauldron Lake.
Well, you ain't wrong, mister. The Indians thought the lake was a doorway to the underworld. I'm the God-fearing type myself. I don't hold with that sort of thing.
Yeah, okay. Anyway, there was an island there owned by a guy called Thomas Zane. Now, some of the articles I found about him make him out to be a famous writer. But I ran a bunch of searches, couldn't find a single thing he wrote. Zane was heavily into diving, so much so that the place came to be called Diver's Isle. But the volcano under the lake erupted in 1970, and Zane went down with the island.
What's up, YouTube? This is Ohio Dopers. Welcome back to my channel. I'm back at it again with Alan Wake. Episode 3. Gameplay. Playthrough 3.
Come on, mister.
So I know it's been a while since I played this game. And the thing is, I like to look around a lot because I like to collect all the thermal cups in this game. Little blue cups you collect. Obviously,
me.
I'm not finding
it's
any
not
right
far.
Now. Checkpoint reach. Let me check over here.
Listen, I got things to do. This place don't run itself. Yeah, how about that? It was there in the morning, as if it had fallen from the sky. But it would take a tornado to lift something like that. We're damn lucky it didn't crush any of the trailers.
Right there, see? Those I'm trying to collect. Trying to make sure I get all of them. Hopefully I got
break,
all of them.
Mister, can we just get a move on?
A local girl, Barbara Jagger, drowned in Cauldron Lake just a week earlier. They were lovers.
Sure, Jagger's a local spook story. The Scratching Hag comes for you in the dark. childish stuff like that.
Anyway, Al, I'm just getting to the best part. All of the articles about this stuff were written by Cynthia Weaver. I asked around, and she's that crazy bag lady you met.
What, the lamp lady? She can be a little loopy, but she's not homeless.
Yeah, anyway, she knew both Jagger and Zane before they both died, and she had some kind of a breakdown.
Well, mister, this here's Rose's trailer. You mind me asking what you want with her?
We're just here to talk to her, pal.
Welcome to... Oh dear, Mr. Wake. I'm so glad you're here.
Rose, you have my manuscript?
Oh. Oh, yes. Yes. Please, come in.
Hey, this is really good.
Rose.
Yes.
My manuscript. I really need it.
I understand. I know what you need. A muse to inspire you.
Oh, for Barry? She doesn't have anything.
Yeah, Hey, Al. Al, what's... Oh...
Barry! What?
What? Put something into the coffee.
It's coming for you. Hiding in my barber's skin. I'm too weak to stop it. You must turn the lights on.
I promised I'd come visit you and your lovely wife. You must finish what you started. I insist.
You must turn the lights on. Turn the light on.
I felt nauseous, hungover. Only anger kept me going.
I can't tell reality from dream anymore, but it seems I have an imaginary editor to help me. She's an old woman in a funeral dress. I call her Barbara Jagger. She's very strict. I'm writing faster and faster. My manuscript is being heavily revised. The edits are getting very aggressive.
Rose took a day from me. I had less than 12 hours left to meet the kidnapper. All I could do was get Barry into the car, work something out once I got on the road.
Welcome to the Oh Dear Diner. What can I get you today? Coffee?
I couldn't work up much hate for Rose. Something had used her to get to me and left its mark. My gun and flashlight were gone. I'd have to find a way to get Barry into the car as quickly as possible. There was no time to waste. Barry was out of it. He was way too heavy to carry.
You're right. I deserve more money. I'm so handsome.
I just stepped outside to catch a breath of fresh air. Let me tell you, the weather's getting heavy. Nights like this make me especially glad I'm here talking to you and not home in bed. Once the weather takes a turn like this, I can't sleep at all. It's all tangled bed sheets and dark floor. Just me?
you're gonna get it now. God knows what you've done to that poor girl.
This is Agent Nightingale, FBI! Get him up, Hemingway! You're under arrest! You move a muscle, I'll unload right in your goddamn face! Stay right where you are, Slade!
Right here, you goddamn maniac!
I hated to leave Barry behind, but there was no way I'd miss my appointment with the kidnapper.
Give it up, Mr. Wake! Come on!
Get after him! Don't let him get away! Move it! I'm having shots when you let him get away!
He was right there!
Come on, guys! We need to head him off!
This horror was everywhere I went, circling me. The cops didn't stand a chance. They were after a writer, not a monster.
Thank you.
broadcast tower in the distance was part of the local radio station. Maine seemed like a decent guy. Perhaps he could give me directions to the coal mine.
Let's see what's up here.
I could see the lights at the radio station in the distance.
This is Jane. Mulligan, Thornton, come in. Over.
Thornton here. Jane, we got both Wheeler and Rose in custody. They didn't put up a fight or anything. Why, they were... Hey!
Unnatural shadows clung to the gate. The darkness that was after me was trying to stop me. I wouldn't get through without a light. There was no power to the searchlight. Generator conked out. I'd have to see if I could fix it and try again. It took me a moment to recognize the flashbang grenades. They were an ideal weapon for my situation.
Team 1, come in. Over. Team 1, this is Sheriff Breaker. Report. Over.
The call. You're on KBFFM with Pat Maine.
It's Milt Peabody, Pat.
What's on your mind, Milt?
Well, I live near the trailer park, Pat, and there's a big ruckus going on over there.
Well, that's just up the road from me, too. What's going on, do you know?
I don't know, but there's a bunch of police cars there, lots of sirens, a helicopter buzzing around, and I think I heard some gunshots.
Gunshots?
Yes, sir, like from a pistol. So can you find out what's going on? Because it's just next door and they're popping off guns there.
They're still shooting?
No, it was maybe 10, 15 minutes ago. It sounds serious, Pat. I'm telling you, it don't sound like no party.
I'm certainly going to give the station a call, Milt.
I hope Maine could lend me a car to get to the coal mine.
Pat, it's Lorna Miles.
Why, hello, Lorna. What do you have for us?
Well, I just don't see why the cops bothered with the trailer park.
What do you mean?
It's a trailer park. Of course you're going to have trouble with a place like that.
Thank you very much for that compassionate viewpoint, Lorna. Oh, here's a little surprise, the famous writer Alan Wake just walked in. Folks, I'm going to see if I can talk him into an interview.
Come on in, Mr.
Wake. Oh, I'm so glad you could find the time to do this, Mr. Wake.
Nowhere to run now, James Brown. You back away from me. Don't hurt.
Whoa. Everyone calm down. Put the gun down. We're all friends here, right?
Cool your jets, Nightingale. We got him. What the hell's the matter with you? There's a civilian in there.
I'll get you yet, even if it kills me. You hear me? You hear me, H.P. Lovecraft?
I had fallen off so many cliffs, it was ridiculous. That's what you get for naming a book The Sudden Stop. It was probably good I hadn't had the chance to tell Maine where I was going. I'd have to lose the cops and find my own way to the mine. There was no sensible reason for the power company lights to be here. It was almost as if they'd been left for someone like me to use.
Thank you.
There's gotta be a way to climb up that. Used to dream people. So I can't go this way.
Hello?
The most stubborn man I've ever met.
Alice? Alice?
Alan. I'm so afraid. It keeps me in the dark. Please help me. I look at you, Alan, and it's not you. Something else. Looking out from behind your eyes.
Alice, I'm here.
I'm so alone here. It's all gonna go to hell. You need to be careful. Cooperate.
The connection had been terrible, but that wasn't the only thing that hadn't been right with the call. She sounded wrong somehow, but she had called me. I could see a railway bridge up ahead and a warehouse of some sort on the opposite shore. I hoped I could find a car from there. Everything in its path.
Oh, stay.
I could find a car from there.
I don't have no type of... I have no flares, no flash bombs, no nothing.
Pursuing me was growing stronger, and it was taking over everything in its path. Find a car from there.
I have no flares.
Everything in its path. I hoped I could find a car from there.
Let me see if I could find some flares. This one I need it. I got 3 foot, that should be enough.
The darkness that was pursuing me was growing stronger, and it was taking over everything in its path.
What the hell?
hoped I could find a car from there.
Then I have to go back and get the freaking soil. Really?
Hoped I could find a car from there.
Oh boy.
That was pursuing me was growing stronger, and it was taking over everything in its path.
Thank you. finally.
As a teenager, just starting to get interested in writing, Stephen King had been a source of inspiration to me. I thought about all the inanimate objects that had come to life in his books. No one is safe in a good horror story, certainly not the protagonist. That's what makes them fun. This was anything but. The darkness could possess anything, and it was getting closer.
Thermal. Just come out of nowhere. If you're focusing on one person in the light, you can't hurt them. Like if you're focusing on one person, then another person's gonna come from the side. Like I'm a fight a boss.
Yeah.
never been this glad to see the sunrise. I had a couple of hours to get to the coal mine. The coal mine wasn't far now. Today, I would meet the kidnapper, and he would give me Alice. I wouldn't give him any other choice. A drowning man will clutch at a straw.
Wait a minute. How do you get out of there?
Little by little, without realizing it, I'd come to believe that the story in the manuscript was coming true. The current of its narrative had taken me deeper and deeper into dark waters. Alice had been taken from me. Barry was probably in jail. I was a fugitive from the FBI. The whole world taken over by the dark presence was trying to destroy me. It all felt real, but it matched a textbook case of insanity.
This is Pat Main, and you're listening to KBF FM. Folks, I want to apologize for kind of abandoning you to that looping music track last night, but I was detained. You see, I encountered a big shot G-Man with an itchy trigger finger who could use it. Oh, let me abandon.
To the point my checkpoint reached.
Welcome back to KBF FM. Hope you enjoyed that too. Now, Doc, you were talking about life and finding that special someone, that soulmate.
Well, you were talking about that. I was saying I don't buy it.
Well, see, to me, that's strange because I always think you know.
On a manuscript.
It was early. I was supposed to meet the kidnapper at noon in the main building. The coal mine was quiet. It was a museum now. I didn't want to go outside. Cops had to be looking for me. The noon sun turned the place into a sauna. The day dragged on. Different scenarios ran through my mind. Ways of how I'd torture the kidnapper to get Alice back. Or the different horrible things he could have done to her. I imagined her dead. I had no way of knowing she was still alive. It was killing me. I was running on blind hope. It was all a waste of time. The bastard never showed up.
Wake! Where the hell are you?
Change of plans. You know where Mirror Peak is? It's a big mountain north of where you are. You follow the path from the mine, you can't miss it. There's a lookout point there. I'll be waiting.
I'm through being jerked around
by
you.
You want to see your wife alive? Because if you do, you better watch what you say to me. Do we understand each other?
I want to talk to Alice.
Yeah, and I want the manuscript. Don't keep me waiting, Wake.
Hello? Hello!
I'm gonna kill him!
I had to get to Mirror Peak. Closer than ever before.
How do I get down?
Thank you.
press my... I gotta do this crap again. Let's get ready.
The only way to reach the hillside ahead was to go through the building. I had to find a way to avoid electrocution.
Thank you. had a feeling a bunch of them was gonna come out. Trust no one in the dark.
There was no way the flashbang grenades were standard power company equipment.
I see a thermal cup there. Charge me. Oh, no, you did it. Wow. For this first, because
I had no real plan. I was going to give the kidnapper all the manuscript pages I had for Alice. If that wasn't enough, I'd hold him at gunpoint and make him talk. The dark presence was moving ahead of me in the same direction I was going. A cold feeling settled itself in the pit of my stomach. Was it going for Alice?
Thank you.
The place was dead, a ghost town. Had been for decades, maybe a century. I needed a key for the door. Outside of riding is a struggle. I feel ill. I managed to make my way downstairs. There's a shoebox filled with books and papers by Thomas Zane. It's very hard to focus, but I managed to read some of it. He's a poet, and a good one. He writes of muses and creators summoning fabulous things from a magic lake, using his powers to shape the world of a realm of gods and dreams and demons, dark things that wait for a chance to slip through, wearing the flesh of men as disguise. Zane writes about himself, his girlfriend being taken over by a dark presence, about growing scared of the lake. Kidnapper had sent me a text. The message was full of spelling errors and insults. It was telling me to hurry up. Without warning, the headache stabbed at my brain.
Thank you.
have to make my way up this mineshaft in order to go on. Maybe the machinery could help me with that.
She was on top. You on the manuscript.
Great. Another cable car. Just great.
could see Cauldron Lake. I thought I could make out the spot where the island and the cabin had been. There was a light near it. It had to be a boat. I was close now. I had to get there fast. I dreaded what I would find.
Wait! Are you? Wait!
Hey, I'm here! I'm coming!
No! Get away! Sorry! Please, it's late! The boss didn't know who he was messing with! I didn't know! I swear, I didn't know! We don't have a wife! We don't know where she is! She's probably drowned! We just said we had her to make a play ball, you see? They got him writing for us! Please!
Come on!